Good morning, students. Today's class we are going to see the decimal number system. In decimal number system, we are going to see about the conversion from decimal to hexadecimal. So far we discussed about the decimal to binary, decimal to octal, and now today's class we are going to see in detail about the decimal to hexadecimal conversion. So first one, we'll have a revision on conversion from decimal to octal system, then we'll move to hexadecimal number, then conversion of decimal to hexadecimal number, then conversion of decimal to hexadecimal for fractional number, then for mixed number. Similarly, we'll move to classwork problem and homework problem. What is hexadecimal or base 16 number? The other name of hexadecimal is nothing but base 16 number. So now a hexadecimal number is a number where each digits may be one of 16 possible value. The 16 possible values are the numbers from 0 to, numbers are from 0 to 9, and the letters from A to F. I told you in the beginning we have to use only the capital letters, students. So now what is this A? A stands for the number 10, B for 11, C 12, D 13, E 14, F 15. So now hexadecimal number. See, for example, A is also a hexadecimal number. 9, yes, of course, it's a hexadecimal number. So don't confuse with that. The hexadecimal should have both numbers and letters. Don't confuse with that. That's wrong. It may have only the numbers or it may have only letters. So yes, the hexadecimal number does not have to contain letters. It's meaning that doesn't have, or it is not a compulsory to have the combination of both numbers and letters. It may have only the letters or it may have only the numbers. The only thing is we have to see the base. So the 9, you can ask that it may be a decimal. Yes, of course, it is a decimal number. But here I have given that it is a valid hexadecimal number. We have to mention with the base. And the third example, it is a combination of 1001. So you may think that it is a binary number. Of course, it is a binary number, and but it is a hexadecimal number also, because I am going to give like a base 16. So then it's a combination of both letters and numbers. It's also a hexadecimal number. See here, it consists of only the combinations of alphabets. It is also a hexadecimal number. These all are the examples of hexadecimal numbers. So understand the specific hexadecimal number means we have to convert into equivalent decimal number. So first one, we'll move to hexadecimal number system. So it is a revision. Again, it has a base 16 and it has 16 digits 0 to 9 and A to F. And example, this is one of the example of hexadecimal number. And the positional number system is represented like this in the hexadecimal number. It's starting from 16 power 0, that is your units, then tens, hundreds, thousands, etc. 16 power 0, 16 power 1, 16 power 2, 16 power 3, etc. So these are the some examples of binary to hexadecimal numbers. So these things I will discuss in the upcoming classes. So next one, conversion of decimal to hexadecimal number. What is decimal number? Again, the decimal number system is a system which having the digits from 0 to 9 is known as decimal number system. So the base is 10. What is hexadecimal number? The hexadecimal number has the digits from 0 to 9 and the letters from A to F. So totally 16 digits. So the base is 16. So next one, decimal to hexadecimal number conversion. What is the method which we are using here? It's of course a hexadecimal method. So here I'll give you a reminder. The conversion from decimal to binary is called double-double method. Decimal to octal is called octal-double method. Whereas the decimal to hexadecimal is called, decimal to hexadecimal is called hexa-double method. Then what is hexadecimal method? That is, the decimal number is divided by the digit 16. So these all are the steps. Again, we have to write the given number and divide it by 16, that is the base. We have to write the remainder, divide the quotient by 16, and we have to continue the steps till it reaches 0. Then here I have given the example. the conversion of decimal to hexadecimal for a whole number. See here, this is the best example. 3479, it's a decimal to hexadecimal. So we have to divide it by 16. I have written the quotient here and the remainder here. Next, again, we have to continue the steps. This is the first remainder, this is the second remainder, and the last remainder. The first one is called least significant bit. The last one is called most significant bit. As usual, we have to write the result from bottom to top. So the final answer is 3479, and this 10 denotes the base of decimal. The answer is D97. So the base is 16. The 16 denotes it is a hexadecimal. So by looking the answer, we can say that we have converted from decimal to hexadecimal number. Decimal to hexa conversion. So this is another example. So I left you with the homework problem. You just take down this problem in your note and work it out. And finally, we'll check the answer. So the answer is 61C. So next one, decimal fraction to hexadecimal fraction. As usual, we have to go with the successive multiplication method. So the given number should be multiplied by 16, and we have to write the result. And the carry is 1, the fraction is 0.0048. And we have to continue the steps till it reaches 0. Or otherwise, we can stop up to 4 or 5 steps. And finally, we have to write the answer from top to bottom. So the answer is 0.1013. So here we have converted from decimal fraction into hexadecimal fraction. So next one is for mixed numbers. Mixed number, you know very well that we have to go with the same procedure. What is that? So I left it with the open discussion. I think somebody has an answer for this question. So for mixed number means it is combinations of integers and fractional number. Integer, we have to go with the successive division method. That means we have to divide it by 16. And for the fraction, we have to go for successive multiplication method. We have to multiply by 16. Same procedure we have to follow. So I don't want to put a problem on this mixed number. I'll give you a homework problem. You just work it out in your note and submit it as assignment for a in a Google Classroom. So, and this table gives an exact conversion from decimal to binary, decimal to octal, and decimal to hexadecimal. Just go through it later in the upcoming classes. And these all are the classwork on homework problem. I have given a list. Just work it out in your note, take a scan or a photocopy and paste it in your, submit it in your assignment page. Thank you, students.